Hello everybody, welcome, happy Saturday. This is... Hello and welcome everybody, especially my 25 beautiful, wonderful, and loyal subscribers. We're out here, or I'm out here in Laguna Beach, hiking. It's been a little bit tough with all the stuff going on during the pandemic, so taking this time to really decompress and relax. So this pandemic has gotten really serious over the last 6 months, and it's forced us to socially distance and physically distance. So a lot of us aren't really being connected, and sometimes we feel isolated and alone. I know as someone working in a hospital who rounds on some of the COVID units, that can be tough to be connected, especially as someone that lives at home. I live with my family and quarantine in my own room, and I wear masks every time I go out of my room. So a lot of my family and friends don't want to be that close to me. I know it's been really tough for a lot of our healthcare workers and pretty much anyone that's been isolated at home to feel connected. So I wanted to make this video and share 5 simple tips to improve your social wellness. I'm not saying that these tips will dramatically change things overnight, but with time and practice, making these small changes can make a big difference in improving your social wellness. Just so you know, I have my mask right here for those who are wondering where it is. I only take it off when I talk with you guys, but there's no one else around here, so things are pretty safe for now. So before I dive deeper into this topic of social wellness, I wanted to make a distinction between health and wellness. So while all of us are really healthy right now, we're in a state of neutral and passive existence. We all have healthy bodies, but we don't have wellness. We don't have social wellness because we're not performing at an optimal level. Fun fact, there's actually 8 dimensions of wellness, and these 8 dimensions are interconnected and ultimately determine how well we feel on an overall level. So the 8 dimensions include your physical wellness, intellectual wellness, emotional, financial, environmental, social, occupational, and spiritual dimensions. And these dimensions together help us become a greater version of ourselves. So you want to make sure that all these dimensions are accounted and taken care of. This pandemic has really taken a negative toll on our social wellness, and it's caused a lot of us to feel isolated and alone. And loneliness can occur because we don't feel connected to another person, another group, or a type of cause. So the first tip in improving your social wellness is to create a more consistent routine. And I'll admit, I usually think that I am a disciplined and structured person, but I realized that a lot of my routines aren't really consistent during the weekends. I found myself going to bed late on Friday nights, reading a book or watching a movie, and this led to detrimental effects. I woke up the next day feeling a little bit more fatigued and a little bit disgruntled, and I could have prevented that by being more consistent and sleeping a little bit earlier or at my usual bedtime. I also noticed that I wasn't meditating before I was going to work. I usually meditate 5 to 10 minutes a day, but I wasn't doing that when I was going to work. I was really excited and eager to be the first person there at work, and I'd rush in the morning. I didn't give myself an opportunity to center myself and collect my thoughts. So once I became aware of this and was honest with myself, I was better able to create an actionable plan. And these were really small steps I took to wake up earlier in the morning and meditate and go to bed at a consistent time Friday through Sunday. I know it seems a little bit strict, but having self-discipline is a great form of self-love, and loneliness comes from a gap between the relationships that we have and the relationships that we want. So cultivating some self-love is a great way to lessen the gap and reduce any feelings of anxiousness and boredom that stem from feeling a little bit alone. The second tip to improve social wellness is to reach out. And reaching out can be through different mediums, whether it is FaceTime, phone call, Zoom, or Microsoft Teams. But each method is always a way to connect with others that you might not be connected with on a day-to-day basis. Whew, kind of tired actually. Let me breathe a little bit harder. I'm actually wearing a vest here, 10-pound vest, because I'm not getting a lot of my strength and weight training that I get in a gym. But just a small life hack. Reaching out was a little bit more difficult for me simply because of my ego. I didn't want to seem needy, and I didn't want to be the first person that always reached out. But I took a risk and it paid off well. What I found out by reaching out to some of my friends was that they were also going through a tough time and were really appreciative that I took the time to reach out and check up on them. a lot of them were either starting new jobs and adjusting or struggling to cope with a lot of the things that were going on because of the pandemic. So having me reach out really started a continuous dialogue that allowed us to connect and feel more socially well. And now a lot of the people that I reached out to oftentimes reach out to me and check up on me to see how I'm doing. So it's a mutually beneficial exchange just by taking the initiative to reach out and see how people you care and love for are doing. For those with older relatives, taking the initiative to reach out for those who live by themselves and might wish for company is also something you can do to connect with people that you also care for. By the way, I know what you guys are thinking. This is not my house. It is my mom's house. Just kidding. We just hiked all the way from kind of the bottom. I don't know if you can see it here. And at the top, there are houses. So I guess this is what happens when you make it big on YouTube. Speaking of reaching out to older relatives that live by themselves, the third tip in improving social wellness is to volunteer. You know, there are a lot of volunteer organizations where you can actually hop on a virtual call and speak with those that might feel lonely. Other virtual volunteering options include tutoring, reading books to kids, and also mentoring. There are a lot of younger people that need mentors. So if you feel like you've learned something that you can share with someone else, volunteering is a great way to be connected to a social cause that you genuinely believed in. I've been fortunate enough to join a lot of organizations and make a difference in causes that are important to me. And I was able to meet people with shared values and beliefs and connect with them on a deeper level. And when I say deeper level, I'm not talking about a romantic relationship. However, there are those that actually meet their significant others through volunteering. That might be a little bit more difficult because of COVID, but hey, if you're looking for love and wanted an opportunity to do that, why not take your shot? As Wayne Gretzky and Michael Scott once said, you miss 100% of the shots you don't take. Another alternative form of volunteering is volunteering at home. A lot of people think that you have to volunteer with an external organization, but you can really be more intentional by volunteering at home and washing more dishes, taking out the trash, helping family and parents to really make home a better place. And you'll feel more connected, not just to your parents and your family, but also to your living space. I admittedly am not the best volunteer at home, but having this awareness and intentionality to improve has really helped me take small steps to making home a cleaner and better place to live. I also might need to start taking better care of my hair. This wind has made it look a little bit crazy. Ooh, I have this maybe wax. If anyone has any wax or pomade recommendations, please let me know. With that being said, the fourth tip to improve your social wellness is to have an accountability partner. You know, in this life, we all have dreams and goals that we want to accomplish, and sometimes it can be difficult to do them or accomplish them by yourself. And that's where an accountability partner comes in. Having a partner with a shared objective and vision definitely helps you push along and move closer to the goals that you want to accomplish. Something that I always wanted to do over the past few years was to start and complete the Insanity training program. And for those of you who don't know what Insanity is, it's basically an advanced high intensity interval training program that lasts about 2 months. And me being someone that's more averse to high intensity cardio, especially because I have asthma, I don't really like doing cardio. So having an accountability partner definitely pushed me and made sure that I didn't quit when things got difficult. Having an accountability partner also increases your social wellness by increasing your connectivity. You're connected to a goal and you're connected to at least one other person in achieving the goals that you set out. Now I'm looking down a little bit because I'm going through these difficult parts of the hike, but as I was saying, accountability partners can really help you achieve what you wouldn't do by yourself. As we conclude this hike and reach the end of the trail, it brings us to our last and final tip to improve social wellness. And it's actually something that I'm really excited to share because it's something that I've been doing a lot. I've been dating myself. I know it sounds a little bit cheesy, but I think the premise of the phrase is that you should cherish and savor the time you spend with yourself. A lot of times we think that if we find the right person at the right time, they'll end up completing us and filling the gap in our lives. However, something we should also consider is whether we can fill that gap ourselves. is that gap in our lives between the relationships that we want and the relationships that we have caused by someone else, or is it caused by you? And when I say you, I'm not talking about you, my wonderful, loyal, and beautiful subscriber. I'm talking about us as individuals. Are we taking initiative and taking accountability to make sure our lives are the best that they can be? Are we going on those hikes that we always wanted to go on? Are we trying the foods that we always wanted to try? And are we watching the sunsets that we always wanted to watch? These are things to always consider as you're trying to improve your social wellness. Do we really need someone to accompany us? Or is a party of one just enough? I hope this video was insightful and inspired new ideas for you to take action in improving your social wellness. If you have any new tips, tricks, or ideas, please feel free to share them with me. I am actively trying to improve my social wellness and am happy to learn any new concepts. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, share, subscribe, and comment below. And I look forward to seeing you guys in future videos. I hope you all take care, do good, and be well.